Welcome to another episode of Tinkerine Experiments. We'll be continuing our experiment from last week regarding PLA buoyancy. Last week, we found out that between 70% to 80% infill is where PLA actually becomes negative or positive buoyancy. Now we're going to narrow down the number. Just like before, I have 10 cubes here with 70% infill all the way up to 80% infill. We'll slowly put in the cubes and find out whether or not they will float. We'll start with what we know. 70 floats and 80% sinks. And then now we will start narrowing it down from 1% at a time from each side. Now we can put in 71% still floating. Next is 79% and it just sunk completely. 72% is next, still floating, and then 78% sinks. Moving on to 73% and then 77%. We are getting close. . 74% is floating, so we are down to 76% and 75%. 76% is sinking, but wait, it's actually coming back up. Well, let's just put in 75% as well. Yep, figures, it is floating. So from this experiment, we can see that it is between 76% to 77% where PLA actually becomes positive or negative buoyancy. So keep this number in mind if you're modeling something that needs to float but also wants it to be really strong and sturdy. Well, there we have it. We found out the exact range regarding the infill percentage for PLA to remain floating. It is between 76% to 77%, so keep that in mind if you are modeling something that needs to be strong and also needs to float. Before I end, I just want to remind everyone about Tinkerine U. The platform has a lot of teaching resources like 3D printing courses, STEAM challenges, and CAD tutorials. So be sure to check it out. That's the end of our experiment. If you liked our video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you did not, then thumbs down below. Remember to subscribe and comment on what experiments you would like to see in the future. Thank you for watching. Tinker out.